What's up guys, my name is Ace, and welcome back to another Gun Guide. This is the series where I go into great detail with all of the stats of every one of the weapons in COD World War II. In today's episode, we're going to be covering the MG15. And first up, as always, let's have a look at some of the real life stats. The MG15 is a German light machine gun that was actually designed more so for aircraft and not for infantry use. So historically, you didn't actually have people on the battlefield carrying these around like we do in World War II. The MG15 fires an 8mm Mauser at approximately 1,000 rounds per minute, so extremely fast. In COD World War II, with the MG15, we get a damage profile of 30-24, and that means it's always going to be a 4-5 shot kill. One thing to keep in mind with this, we're going to be looking at the ranges in a little bit. The range drop off, where this actually drops off to that 5 shot kill, is so extremely far that this gun is essentially a 4 shot kill at all ranges. Our rate of fire is 722 rounds per minute, so a little bit slower than the real life version of the MG15. And with rapid fire, we bump that up to 769 rounds per minute. Our statistical minimum time to kill is going to be 249 milliseconds in the 4-shot kill range, which, like I said, is going to be 99.9% of your gunfights. Moving on to headshots, we get a standard headshot multiplier at 1.1, and this takes our damage up to 33 for a headshot within the 4-shot kill range. And this essentially means that headshots aren't really doing anything for you. It's still going to take 4 shots to the head up close to get a kill. Getting into our ranges, just like with the other LMGs I've showed so far, I can't really show you the range of this gun because the range drop-off is so extremely long, it's 127 meters, that I can't think of a practical line of sight in this game at all that extends out to that range. Even in the war game modes, if you're trying to keep yourself at a distance, you're probably not going to reach 127 meters, and therefore, like I said, this gun is going to be a 4-shot kill in basically every situation you'll ever find. As for hardcore, it's a 30 damage within that 4-shot kill range, so that means it's going to be a 1-shot kill unless you're shooting through cover at any practical range you'd be able to find. Moving on to hipfire, the MG15 has the best hipfire in the LMG category, and it's more in line with a lot of the rifles in this game. And for idle sway, as you can see here, there is almost no idle sway whatsoever with this gun. It should never affect your ability to hit your target, even at really long ranges. As for recoil, this gun doesn't really have too much recoil at all. It bounces around within a relatively contained area, and I would say out to mid ranges, you should have no problem with recoil whatsoever. Having said that, for longer ranges, I feel like this probably isn't your best bet, as it does kick side to side a little bit, and it is slightly uncontrollable within that somewhat contained area, like I said. Getting into our magazine capacity, we get a great standard magazine capacity at 50 rounds with 100 in reserve, and with extended mags, that will actually bump up to 75 rounds with 150 in reserve, so plenty of ammo to go around with this gun. And when we do need to reload, this has the fastest reload add time in the game for the LMG category at 4.49 seconds. It's still not fast by any means, but it is the fastest in the category. Speaking of being the fastest in the category, our aim down sight time is also fastest out of all of the LMGs at 330 milliseconds. The standard is 350 milliseconds, so we're talking like one frame faster than the other LMGs to aim down sight. And our sprint out time does match that at 330 milliseconds. Our movement speed is standard for the LMGs at 92.5%, and our aim down sight strafe speed is also standard for LMGs at 38%. Getting into my recommended attachments, because it is an LMG, I always run quick draw on my LMGs, so that's basically a must-have for me. Extended mags can be great. I mean, it already has a great 50-round magazine, but sometimes it's nice to bump that up to 75 so we don't have to reload quite as often. FMJ is always great for LMGs. It just allows you to spray through those walls a little bit better and get those kills through the walls. And finally, the last attachment that I really enjoy using on the MG15 is Steady Aim. I normally wouldn't recommend that with the LMGs, but this one does have a pretty good fire rate and already has a great hipfire spread for LMGs, so making this a little bit tighter makes it a lot more competitive up close against SMGs and rifles. So getting into a couple example classes I have for you guys, first up we have the Infantry Division here, we've got Quick Draw, Extended Mags, and FMJ, and our basic training is Hunker. With this class, we get the versatility of having that extra attachment as well as the ability to strafe a little bit faster when we're aiming down sight, which is very, very valuable in gunfights. And we also use Hunker because a lot of the times with basically any LMG, what you're doing is you're locking down a lane or locking down an area, and usually you're making a lot of noise and you will often attract grenades, so it's awesome to have that Hunker perk equipped. And then for our secondary and lethal, you can use really whatever you want here. I'm just using a Luger with extended mags and a sticky grenade for my lethal. As for a slight variation, and the second class I'm going to be showing you guys for an example, this is with the Armor Division, so it does allow us to deploy that bipod if we wanted to. And we also get the added ability of being able to take stuns as well as nades a lot more effectively than just using infantry with Hunker. Once again, we're using quick draw and extended mags, but this time we're also using steady aim. This allows me to get into those close quarter situations with a bit more confidence against some of the other guns in the game. Our basic training is primed for this one, and I really just like the fact that you get the extra attachment. That's the primary reason I'm using primed. But having said that, it still does slightly reduce your flinch as well, which will help in gunfights. Once again, our secondary is a Luger with extended mags, and our lethal is a sticky grenade. So overall, the MG15 I feel to be a very fun to use LMG in this game. It doesn't have the fastest time to kill in the world, but it's a pretty consistent time to kill, and there's nothing really wrong with it. And I feel like if you haven't given this LMG a shot, I highly encourage you to do that. Try to keep your gunfights at those mid sort of ranges, and you should be able to find some success. As always, before we wrap this up, I'd love to know in the comment section below, what do you guys think of the MG15? Also, please let me know which one of the weapons you'd like me to cover next for this series. Keep in mind, with a couple of the ones that we're expecting some changes on, like the M1 Garand, I am going to hold off until the changes actually happen. It was a little disappointing to see I had the gun guide all ready to record for the M1 Garand, but then it turned out we got that message from Condry saying they were going to be changing it, so I am definitely going to hold off on that one, as well as a few other ones like the Kar98. If you enjoyed the video, a like rating is always appreciated, and don't forget to subscribe for more if you haven't already. I'll talk to you guys next time.